One of the most exciting developments in the MicroGDS 2010 release is the introduction of intelligent objects. These take MicroGDS a step further into the BIM world in a strategy that has been dubbed Building Lifecycle Management. Now, at the moment, most of the advances are under the hood, an implementation of a technology that makes it possible for anyone to extend the BIM capabilities of MicroGDS. This uses an advanced ADK, an application development kit. Ultimately, a comprehensive range of IFC-compliant objects will become available. At the moment, in this 2010 release, there are a small range of intelligent objects based on this technology. These demonstration videos are intended to give you a taste of what can be done now with these intelligent objects and encourage you to explore the potential for yourself. We'll begin by taking a look at how we set up MicroGDS to use these intelligent objects. One of the great strengths of MicroGDS has always been the full integration of 2D and 3D data. If we look at the view we've got on screen right now, that shows a simple example. What we have here is a 2D structural grid and labels overlaid on a 3D building base and a 3D simple site surface. It's the same with intelligent objects. They're fully integrated into the same environment. What that means, of course, is that you can edit simultaneously the 2D, 3D and intelligent object data so that everything remains coordinated. Now, intelligent objects aren't enabled automatically. You have to tell the project or the single user document that you're going to be using intelligent objects. Now, if we look at the view on screen, down the left-hand side, there's a new icon in the view controls for drawing style. If I click on that, you can see that it just says automatic. That tells me that intelligent objects are not enabled for this project. To do that, we go to our file menu, select this new entry, style search path, and we have to add, by clicking here, a new entry that we have to type in. We just open the angle brackets, asterisk, microGDS, underscore, common, underscore app data, close the angle brackets, and then BIM. This is the location that's set up by MicroGDS during the installation for all the application data. If MicroGDS installation changed this location at a future release, because you've used this system format, you don't need to update it for every one of your projects and drawings. It's done automatically. So we click on OK. And this time, when we look at our view styles, we have an entry list of options. If we take perspective to set the view style for our current view, we can then orbit until we're happy with the angle, zoom in, alter the view style, so we change our hide mode back to shaded with edges, and then we do view, save view as, and I'm going to call this one perspective. OK. Look again at the list, and we've got here GA for GA plan. Again, we set the view up to the extent that we're happy with. Click on view, save view as, call this one GA plan. Click on OK. And we can do the same again for our detail view. Again, zoom in till we're happy with the location. Sure, we can see everything. Under view, save view as, detail, plan. You can obviously give these any name that you choose. Click on OK. And that's it. We're now set up to start using our intelligent objects.